everyone, welcome to Botany Insider. So this is the fourth part of the developmental biology lecture series, and in this particular lecture we'll be dealing with the topic of cell-cell induction. That is, we'll be understanding about that how the signal from one cell is transported, or how does the signal get transferred from the first cell to the next cell. We'll be understanding about all these in this particular video. But before starting the video, if you haven't yet subscribed to my channel, do not forget to subscribe, and also join me on the Telegram channel. Either use the link given below or just search Botany Insider, you'll be able to search the channel. This was about it. Now let's understand about cell-cell induction. So now, before starting that what it actually is or what the mechanism is, we need to understand about that what or why it is given the name of cell induction. So it consists of two words. The first one is signal and the second one is induction. Signal means the message, the important information that need to be transported, and induction means the process that is being used. So it refers to the cascade of the signaling events during which a cell or tissue signal to the other cell or the tissue in order to influence its developmental fate. Now, what is developmental fate? We have discussed about all this in the previous lecture. This is the last part of the basic processes or the basic things that are required to understand the developmental unit. So watch those three videos. In addition, complete this video as well for you to have a holistic understanding about the various terms, and then you'll be able to understand about all the other processes or all the other topics like the Drosophila and all the other ones in a better way. Now, signal induction means, let's consider this is the first cell and let's consider this is the other cell. Let's name it as cell A and cell B. Now, as in when we have a signal in the first cell, it need to be transported to the second cell. That means we have understood in the last section or in the last video about that what developmental fate is. It is the fixing of, or it is the ordering by the stem cells to the other cells to develop into a specific cell type. So this is what developmental fate is, in simple words we can say. So let's say this is the stem cell, and this stem cell have to order this particular undifferentiated cell to convert into the brain cell. This is just an example. So this stem cell would be giving out some signals to the second cell, and for this process what is required is, the important thing that is required is signal induction. That is, this particular cell need to provide the signal to the second cell, that is the B cell. This is what the signal induction is all about. And how does this occur? This occurs through a cascade of the signaling events. Cascade means the sequential process, that means one after the other. So when one after the other signaling events occurs, as a result of that, the first cell orders to the second cell that you have to develop into a specific type. So this is what signal induction is all about. Now, what are the various components of a signal induction? Let's say we have this cell A and this cell B. So from this cell we are giving out some signals, and this cell is receiving that signal. So now, for receiving these signals, what is required is, we require, or there are three main steps. The first step is the signal perception. That means when the cell A have given the order to the cell B would be perceiving, it would be receiving the signal. So for receiving the signal, first step would be the signal perception, and after the signal perception, the second step, now the signal has reached to this particular cell. The B cell have now the signal for itself ki mujhe ye kaam karna hai. Now for that matter, second step would be the intracellular signal transduction. After the second cell have perceived the signal, it would be providing signal to the internal of components, or to the internal components of the cell, in order to perform over that function. So we would be having a intracellular signal transduction. What is intra? Intra means in between. In between means this cell is having some components in it and it needs to signal out those particular components as well to function out. So for that, intracellular signal transduction is required. So this is the second step, and after the intracellular signal transduction, the third step is the cellular response. That is, first step is the signal would be perceived, second step is the cell would be ordering its components inside the cell to function in a specific manner, and in the third process the cellular response would happen. That means after the cell have ordered its component to function in a particular way, now the cellular response would be there, and finally the process of the signal transduction would be completed. We would be having a ligand, we would be having a receptor. What is a ligand? So for this particular thing, we'll be dealing about all this in the communications unit, that is unit number 4. For the time being, just understand the signal that is being given out by the first cell, this is what is the ligand. Now this ligand is perceived by the cell or the receiver cell by the help of a receptor. Now this receptor would be transducing the signal to the various components, and finally we would be having the cellular response in the cell. So this is what cellular transduction is all about. Let's move forward. Now we have the two main components. The first one is the inducer and the second one is the responder. So how does this occur? We have just understood. So inducer is the one that is providing the order, and the responder is the one which would be acting upon or which would be receiving the signal. So for example, we have the stem cell. Now this stem cell have been working as an inducer. It would induce any undifferentiated cell. Let's say this cell, it is given the name B in consideration. Now this B cell would work as a responder, and after perceiving the signal, and the second step would be the intracellular response, and the third one would be it would be acting or it would be providing the final response. It would be showing out the final response as given by the inducer. So this is what the process of signal transduction is all about. Now what is competence? Till now we have understood about that what signal transduction is. Till now we have understood that yes, we have an inducer and we have a responder. Now what is competence? Competence means the ability or the actual strength that this particular responder cell have in order to get the signal, in order to perceive the signal. We'll understand in a better way. So competence in simple word means the ability to respond to a specific inductive signal. The first cell, that is the cell A, had given out the signal, but whether the second cell, the second responder, is competent or not, this depend upon its competency, that its ability to respond to a specific inductive signal. Now how does this occur? So it can occur through the expression of the appropriate receptors of the signaling pathways. For example, the process of eye lens development. We'll be dealing about these topics in the future lectures. So what is competence? Competence in simple word means the ability to respond. What is signal transduction? Cell A, cell B, cell A ne cell B ko signal out pass kiya, and then we would be having the response. But this response, the response of the second cell, would be dependent upon its competence, that how much or how efficient the responder is in order to compete out, in order to work out the specific signal that has been given to it. Now what is commitment? Till now we have understood about that what is signal induction, and we have understood about that what is competence. Now there is one thing, what is commitment? Now we have discussed about that what commitment is, what specification is, in the previous lecture. I have included this particular work in this particular video. Reason being, we have understood about the inductive signal. Now this particular topic can now be correlated to the competence. That is the reason why I have included this particular topic in this lecture. And also the second one is cytoplasmic determinant. So कमिटमेंट के लिए वी रिक्वायर टू थिंग्स. द फर्स्ट थिंग इज द साइटोप्लाज्मिक डिटर्मिनेंट एंड द सेकेंड थिंग इज द इंडक्टिव सिग्नल. सो वॉट इज इंडक्टिव सिग्नल? वी हैव जस्ट डिस्कस, वील बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द सेकेंड वन, दैट इज द साइटोप्लाज्मिक डिटर्मिनेंट. इफ यू हैवेंट येट वॉच्ड अबाउट दैट वॉट द डिटर्मिनेशन और वॉट स्पेसिफिकेशन इज, आई वुड रिकमेंड यू प्लीज वॉच द प्रीवियस लेक्चर. आई प्रोवाइड द लिंक ऑफ द सेम इन द डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स. चेक दैट आउट, गेट योर कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर एंड देन मूव अहेड. फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर वीडियो आई वुड सजेस्ट यू, फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर यूनिट आई वुड सजेस्ट यू दीज इनिशियल फोर लेक्चर्स आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई हैव ट्राइड टू मेक देम एज सिंपल एज पॉसिबल सो दैट इफ यू फाइंड एनी क्वेश्चन इन द एग्जामिनेशन यू कैन ईजिली सॉल्व आउट दोज क्वेश्चंस. These topics are very, very important. Many questions have been asked. So do not make a mistake of skipping these videos. You just have to watch these four videos and then go for the practice of the same. Now let's understand about the first one, that is the cytoplasmic determinant. So cytoplasmic determinant means, just break the term and then try to get the meaning. So determinant is somewhere related to anything that is helping to get determined a particular cell. So it is present in the maternal side. A cell can divide into two daughter cells achieved by the asymmetric distribution. Now how does a cell divide? We have also discussed about this thing as well in the previous lectures in the cell cycle unit. So watch those videos as well. Interlinking of the topics is very, very important. I am repeating it again and again. Do not make a mistake of being in a specific area and studying only a specific topic. Just be dynamic in trying to link the topic as much as possible, because linking of topics is very, very important. Do not make this mistake. Keep it in your mind that you have to link the topics, and this would help you out to solve out the questions in the CSIR and also in other competitive exams. So a cell can divide into two daughter cells and that is achieved by the asymmetric distribution or the cytoplasmic factors. These cytoplasmic factors could either be the RNA or the protein. They act in the early development and they are very important for the development of any organisms. Now, the cytoplasmic determinants, what are they? They are the special molecules which play a very, very important role during the oocyte maturation in the female ovule. During the segmentation, cytoplasmic determinants are distributed among the blastomers at different times depending on the species and on the type of the determinant. That means cytoplasmic determinants, they are a special type of molecules that have an important role during the oocyte maturation, and these cytoplasmic determinants, they are distributed among the blastomers. What are blastomers? So they are the cells which are present during the initial stages of the development of any organisms. We'll be dealing about them in the detail in future lectures at different times depending upon the species and also on the determinant. Now this was about it. Now we have to understand about one more thing, and that is about the types of the induction. We have discussed about that what signal induction is. Now there are two types of signal induction. The first one is the instructive one and the second one is the permissive one. Let's understand about each one of them. The first one is the instructive induction. So what instructive induction is all about? So in this, the signal that is important from the inductive signal is necessary. For example, the stem cells, the tissue here give the instruction to the cell to commit to a specific pathway of the development. So as the word suggests, instructive, that means instruction is being given out. So here the signal is important. Why I am insisting upon the word signal? Because in the second one there is some other point depending upon the same. So just remember that in case of the instructive induction, the signal is very important, and the common example is the stem cells. The tissue here gives the instructions to the cell to commit to a specific pathway. That means, let's consider we have this tissue and we have this particular cell present. So now this tissue would be giving some instructions to this particular cell. Now what happens is, let's consider this is a tissue and this tissue have this particular cell. this cell have already committed, this cell already know that yes, it have to convert into the brain cell. This is just an example, but the permission of this particular environment is required. In the previous one, that is the instructive one, in this, the instruction is required by this cell to commit to a brain cell. But in this case, the cell is already committed, only the permission is required. So permissive means in which the permission is required. Active means in which the instruction or the signal is required that this cell you have to convert into the brain cell. So this was about the permissive and the instructive one. In the permissive, it is the permission is needed by the environment, or the permission is dependent upon the environment. So this was about the complete topic. Let's just quickly summarize what all we have just discussed. So we have understood about that what signal induction is all about in this particular video, and then we understood about that what signal induction is and what are its various types. So just watch the four videos of the developmental biology, you will be able to understand about the complete topic in detail. I hope this particular video was helpful for you. If yes, do let me know in the comment sections below, and do not forget to like, share and subscribe to Botany Insider. Thank you so much everyone for watching, and I'll see you very soon with more informative videos. Till then, take care and keep learning. Bye.